Hi folks, this is David Kwan, and in this video I just want to talk briefly about Metal Gear Solid 5 Phantom Pain and how excited I am for it. That's really the point of this whole video, is just that I'm really excited. I've been trying to stay away from any kind of coverage or teasers or gameplay demonstrations about it because, well, I'm already sold on it. Like, when it comes out, I'm gonna buy it. I played a lot of Ground Zero, so I have a pretty good expectation of what the game is gonna play like, and what the game is gonna look like on my PS3 as well. Although there's gonna be a whole bunch of new settings and new environments and what and new characters in Phantom Pain compared to Ground Zeroes. But, you know, I've really, actually really enjoyed the experience of Ground Zeroes, and my only really complaint is that there isn't enough of it. So Phantom Pain will definitely address that, because it's a bigger game and it's the conclusion of Metal Gear Solid 5 as a whole. So yeah, if Kojima was just like, we're having a media blackout and we're not going to show anything about the game until a month before release, I would actually be okay with that, because you know, at this point we know so much about the game already. This is the story of this game takes place before the events of Metal Gear 1, so it's pretty clear at this point, like, what could be possible events that happened in Metal Gear Solid 5. So, like, that much is known. Ground Zeroes kind of sets up what's going to happen. So, we already know so much about this game that, like, I'm trying to stay away from, like, not knowing too much. Not that I care that much. You know, I don't really care about spoilers that much. I'm not that type of person. You know, before, when Metal Gear Solid Portable Ops came out, you know what I did? Like, I didn't have a PSP at the time, and so I was like, okay, it's gonna take me some time to get a PSP and get Metal Gear Solid Portable Ops. So, but I was still like really hooked on the idea of playing Metal Gear Solid on a PSP. I ended up reading the entire script of Portable Ops before playing the game, so I spoiled myself. The whole, you know, it's like that really is a demonstration of how I really do not care about spoilers. But at the same time, like, I think coming to experience the game like fresh, it's going to be very cool for Metal Gear Solid. You know, in that sense, I think Metal Gear Solid 4 kind of revealed too much before release. You know, there was the that gigantic 15-minute gameplay demonstration, but all Metal Gear Solid games kind of do that nowadays. And then the trailers was just like what was shown on trailer was practically a long cutscene, like, in the actual game. So it was like a direct, like, what, I've already seen this in the trailer, but now I'm actually seeing the game, which I think it kind of does, it makes the game have a less, have an impact when you're actually playing the game. So I think Metal Gear Solid 4 was kind of, in a way, like, too much reveal before the actual launch. And the launch trailer, like, reveals all five locations that you're going to go. You know, the Middle East, the South America, you know, every single place is in there. And then it also reveals the Ray versus Rex fight in that trailer before you play the game, which I think was a bad choice. But anyway, I'm trying to stay away, or I've been trying to stay away from the whatever. But Tokyo Game Show happened. It's Metal Gear, so no matter how hard I try, I'm going to be pulled into it. So I did watch pretty much everything about Metal Gear Solid 5. And yeah, I am still surprised. I am still, like, my excitement level just went up, like, insane. You know, it's amazing that a game can do this when we already know so much about the game, but there's still so many areas that this game can kind of surprise. So I think that's amazing. I'm definitely in the hype train for this. And I have to say, you know, one of the best people kind of doing teaser and trailer analysis or talking about Metal Gear Solid 5 has to be Young Yea. I'm not sure if I'm saying his name correctly, but just his kind of analysis where he kind of gathered together all the supporting evidence for how Quiet can be Chico. I mean, it's not his theory, but it's people's theories from the interwebs, and he gathered it together and he, like, showed it in a 12-minute video. Like, just freaking mind-blowing, you know? So it's stuff like that that gets me, like, even more excited about Metal Gear Solid 5. I know there's a YouTube commenter on some of my videos who are like, you need to talk about Metal Gear and whatnot. So definitely, I still have some things to talk about. You know, I did beat Metal Gear Rising a couple of months ago, so I do want to talk about that. And then one thing I also just want to talk about briefly is about Metal Gear Solid 5's kind of the more controversial story topics and about Big Boss in general. I think I have some things to say about that before the game is released, so I'll make sure to make a video on that. But yeah, just consider me, I'm a Metal Gear fan, so this game just excites me so much. And Tokyo Game Show, like, I think, was happened, and like, I think that was like the only thing that I focused on in the Tokyo Game Show, although there's a whole bunch of other things that were shown. Final Fantasy 15, Bloodborne, a lot of great gameplay footage from all those kind of exciting games. But yeah, I'm a Metal Gear fan. Metal Gear Solid 5 is what has me super, totally excited. Yeah, that's all I have to say. Cheers.